Avid viewers of Subpixel content should by now be intimately familiar with the LEGO Group's Bionicle product line, as I've mentioned it now in a handful of videos, but for those of you who don't know or somehow missed out on the cultural phenomenon known as Bionicle, here's the gist of it. Bionicle was a story-driven, first-person, multimedia intellectual property developed by the LEGO Group, focusing on several lines of physical toys whose narrative was to be told in tie-in multimedia content, including comics, books, movies, and games. Bionicle is arguably one of the LEGO Group's most beloved original franchises, with lines like LEGO's Ninjago the only close competitors, and as such has earned itself a whole mess of digital adaptations over the years, some console-based, some handheld, and some inside your browser. I want to take a look at one of their browser-based titles, developed by French developers Ankama Games, the Voyanui online game. Though similarly named and likely attempting to dovetail off the popularity of Matanui Online Games 1 and 2, Voyanui Online Game could not be more different. While Matanui Online Game was an episodic point-and-click adventure, Voyanui Online is an isometric turn-based RPG set during the events of the 2006 Bionicle storyline. I've long claimed that Bionicle is the perfect property for a robust role-playing game, hashtag give Airship Syndicate the rights to Bionicle, and I know that there are people out there who agree with me, like these madmen who have been working on a total conversion of Skyrim called Legend of the Toa. As with all good mods, it comes from Russia, but that's not what we're here to talk about today. Voyanui Online Game was first announced to be released in December of 2005, but the game was delayed twice, first supposedly launching in spring of 2006, and then finally hitting Bionicle.com in September of 2006. And since the shutdown of Bionicle.com in 2013, exists now as part of the immensely valuable preservation efforts of the Biomedia Project. Now, without getting too much into the preceding 5 years of lore that set up the events of the Voyanui Online game, you control one of the Toa and Ika and are tasked with helping the Matoran resistance on Voyanui rise up against their Paraka captors, Bionicle villains who semi-canonically kidnapped the All-American Rejects. Unlike a bulk of the previous Bionicle games, either on desktop and console, handheld systems, or within an internet browser, Voyanui Online Game allowed players to actually customize their Toa, though only statistically. At the start of the game, you get to pick a character model from one of the six Toa and Ika, and after the start of the game, the appearance of your chosen Toa does not change no matter what items you equip. Various aesthetic customization options were available in a handful of other Bionicle games, but Voyanui Online was one of the first instances where the player was given direct control over the style of play they wanted to pursue. The game that follows is fairly simple in structure. Your end goal is the fabled Mask of Life, which will supposedly be used to wake the long-sleeping Matanui. And on your journey, you'll undertake various fetch quests that culminate in a boss battle with that region's Paraka Overlord, eventually leading to a final showdown with the 7th Paraka at the heart of the island. The gameplay, too, is pretty straightforward, isometric exploration of the island interwoven with turn-based, grid-based combat. And this is where your character customization really comes to bear. You can customize your Toa to be a close-range heavy hitter or a fast-moving ranged assassin, but there's not a ton of depth to the combat beyond that. The enemies are fairly straightforward, with each Paraka adding one unique mechanic or another, but nothing overly fancy. The real draw and charm is the customization. If you're looking for narrative depth, stick with the books and comics, because Voyanui Online Game, while fun in its own novel way, actually makes some mistakes within the greater Bionicle lore. Not much information is available on the development of Voyanui Online, and Ankama has yet to return my email, so I'm not sure about Voyanui Online's development. But for whatever errors were made in regards to the canon of Bionicle, the game was well received by fans, and you too can play it for yourself over on BiomediaProject.com. Biomedia Project is additionally home to dozens, and I mean dozens, an absolutely crazy amount, of other Bionicle browser games that were released by the LEGO Group over the first decade of Bionicle's life. So please, head over there and check them out when you can. Browser games are fast becoming a relic of yesteryear, so it's great to see the lengths the Biomedia Project and others have gone to keep these games alive.
Hey everybody, this is Jake Terrio with Subpixel. If you've made it this far, hopefully it means you enjoyed that video that you just watched. So if you could leave a like and a comment and subscribe if you're not subscribed already, that lets us and our robot overlords at YouTube know that this video is worth watching. So thank you for that, and we'll see you next time.